Hi, in this video I will show you a new script I created to help you create a line with a specific length and angle, and after creating the line you can keep changing the length of the line. This feature I always wanted to have in Max, but for some reason the developers they don't want to do it. I don't know why. So I just created this script that you can install, and if you like to know how to install a macro script, you just you can check the video in the same playlist on how to install a macro script. So now let's use the script. Just click the button here and you will have this dialog box. You have a button to create the line. Here you can specify the length, and here you can specify the initial orientation. And I'm using the word initial because you can specify the angle when you create the line, but after that, if you want to change the orientation, if you want to rotate, you can use the rotate tool in Max. I thought that there is no need to complicate the script since we already have a rotate tool. But what you can do after creating the line is to change the length at any time. So let's do that. First, I will keep the angles 0, and then let's say I wanna create a line with 10 meters, so I'll type 10, or I can use the spinner, then press the create line and press anywhere in the scene. Now, as you can see, I have a line that has a length of 10. If you want to make sure that this is correct, you can go to tape, to helpers, then tape, make sure snap is on and vertex snapping is on. So I can click and drag, and as you can see, it's 10. I will delete the tape. Now you need to select the line to be able to change its length. So now let's say I want this line to be 15.75. As you can see, it changes. You can click and drag also. Now, also to make sure it's correct, just click tape, then, and as you can see, it's 15.75, same as here. So let's continue to draw some lines. So let's say I want a line that goes from here 45 degrees. So I will specify 45 here. Remember that. Don't change the length for the new created line before clicking the create line, because if you change this now, it will affect this current line. So here there is no problem because it doesn't affect the existing line, but here the length it will affect the existing line. So you need to press the create line first, then specify a length, let's say it's 20, then here using snap click here, then I have a line with 20 meters long, and it is rotated on the z-axis 45. Also, if you like to be sure with the tape, just click and drag and it's correct. Now remember this control here, the length, will control the length of the last created line. You cannot modify the old ones. It will only affect the newly created line. So now let's create a line that goes in this direction. I will specify 90 degrees on the z-axis. I can keep this same length, or I will click create line arm. Let's change it to 30. Then click here. Now if I want a line that goes in this direction, I can type 180, press create line, then I can make it 15. Then now let's say I wanna create a line that it is rotated around the y-axis like 45 degrees. I can make this one 0. I can type 45 here, create line, let's make it 40, then click. Now I created a line that is rotated around the y-axis 45 degrees. Now if I want it to be vertical line, if I want to create a vertical line, I can make this angle 90, create line, I can keep it 40 and then click. Now I created a vertical line. Let's make this one 0 again, create line, then click. I will make it minus 90 degrees, keep it the same, create line. If I want to change the length, I can, like, let's make it 70. Remember, you have to select the line first, then press enter. Now it is 70. Yeah, so let's say I want to rotate this line using the rotate tool. Like I said, these controls, they will not affect the line shape. You need to rotate using the rotate command. So I can right click this one and let's rotate this one 45 degrees. I can still control the length. Let's make it 50. Can still play with it. So this is a useful tool if you like to create a 2D floor plans, or you know, it's a it can be useful in many domains. And also there's something else. If you select any of these lines, if you choose let's say I'm going to choose this one. If you click move and you choose local, as you can see, the pivot point is always aligned with the line. So let's say I want to move it in the Z direction parallel to its orientation, I can do that, or I can press the shift and create copies that goes in that goes parallel to its orientation. So I can specify. Also, I can go in this direction, in the Y direction, perpendicular to its orientation. So I can also press the shift and create multiple copies, which is a useful thing also. So, hope you like this video. And basically, that's it. So If you like to support this channel, please subscribe and press the like button. And see you next time. Thank you for watching.